Hello everyone and welcome. In this video we are checking out the Fiat 124 Spider Abarth, and we've got the manual transmission. So I have previously tested the 124. I did quite enjoy it, but it wasn't the Abarth, and it also had the automatic transmission. So what are the changes for this particular model? Well, there are some engine tuning differences, and one of the cool things that they do is with the sport button, you get peak torque earlier on. So now, if you put it in sport mode with this little button behind the shifter, you get your 184 pound-feet of torque at 2,500 RPM rather than at 3,200 RPM. You also do have slightly more power, 164 horsepower rather than 160 for the base model. And I quite enjoyed the 124 with the automatic, but you know, it's not quite the same when you don't get to shift the gears yourself. And the automatic gearbox for the 124, you know, it didn't have paddle shifters. It does for the Abarth version if you do get the automatic. And it does quite change the driving experience. Now this is a pretty lightweight car, you know, based on the MX-5, a little bit heavier than it, you know, 100 or so extra pounds. But what the difference is this is turbocharged, and so you've got 22 PSI, which is crazy, out of the 1.4 liter, versus, you know, the MX-5, of course, has the 2 liter naturally aspirated with a higher compression ratio, does decent torque, but you don't get the low end torque that you get in this car, which is a joy. And on these nice curvy roads, it is absolutely a blast. So let's work through the different systems. A little bit of a rainy day here, so not, you know, perfectly ideal for testing. You do get a lot of feedback, you know, from the tires. You actually feel what's going on the road. I just got out of the Jaguar F-Pace, and so it's a very stark contrast of what I was just driving. You know, of course it's an SUV, so it's big and floaty, but there was no feedback at all, and it's nice to be able to actually feel what's going on with the road in this, know what's going on with the tires. You've got a nice direct steering system with, you know, it's not a real heavy weight to it, but it does have a good on-center feel, and it is very precise as far as turning in and getting response out of it. There you can definitely hear the turbo spooling up when you've got it high RPM in second. There definitely is some turbo lag to it. You know, they say peak torque is at 2,500 RPM with the sport button engaged in the Abarth. And, you know, when you put your foot down, you do wait a little bit and you feel that boost build up. It's got a good amount of torque to it, though, you know, and these cars typically don't. They're not really cars that kind of plant you in your seat when you put your foot down. But this one actually has some pretty good grunt to it and, you know, nice aggressive gearing so that you're getting into that peak torque and staying there. You really get planted in your seat. I mean, I'm at about 5,000 RPM at 40 miles per hour, so pretty aggressive as far as the gearing is concerned, which, you know, I like. I think that's the ideal way to do it, especially for lightweight cars like this that don't have huge engines and don't create a ton of torque. You want to use that gearing to help give you, you know, that nice plant yourself feeling. There is some progression to the throttle pedal. I mean, there is turbo boost, but you know, you also do have control with it. You know, there's a large amount of travel to that throttle pedal, and depending on where you are, there is a significant difference in how that feels. So you do have good control, which, you know, not all modern electronic throttle bodies give you, so it does feel pretty good. As far as the braking, we've definitely heard squeaking. That might be because it's a little wet, or perhaps there's a rock or something in there. You know, it's interesting. It seems like there's kind of two phases to it. There's an initial push where you get a light amount of braking, and then you kind of dive into this second area where it gets much more aggressive, and then, as you can hear, the wheels locking up there. You know, one of the things I faulted the S2000 when I was doing a comparison with that versus this was the brakes and the braking feel, and I think a lot of that had to do with the tires. I wouldn't necessarily say, from a braking standpoint, this feels superior to the MX-5, but you've got plenty of control there and it doesn't feel bad. Now, as far as the shifting, actually pretty smooth shifts, and it's direct. You know, it's got a nice kind of clicks into place as you place that gear. I actually quite like it. This is based, I believe, on the NC Miatas, the previous manual transmission for it, versus the ND. The newest Miata has a different transmission. I don't have any problem with this. I mean, I think the biggest thing is that they kept the gearing aggressive, and I do like that. I mean, the great thing about these vehicles that you really don't get to experience in anything else, period, is just how lightweight they are. And as a result, there's this responsiveness that you otherwise never feel. And so, you know, they're truly a joy to drive. And it's something that, you know, basically no matter how much you spend, you don't get to experience, because more expensive cars tend to have larger engines and they tend to weigh more. And so with this, you know, you get this package where the turbocharger, you've got good low-end torque, you know, you can plant yourself back in the seat, and all the while you've got this super nimble, super playful ride that's just truly a joy to drive. So I do have a hard time, you know, picking between this and the MX-5. There is something that's very fun, of course, about having a turbocharger and getting significantly more torque to the wheels than you do in the MX-5. You do have a little bit more heft, and, you know, you do feel that. You do feel that weight difference, but it's a fun vehicle. So thank you guys for watching, and if you have any questions or comments, of course, feel free to leave those below.